Good day everyone, welcome to Señor Pablo TV. And for today's tutorial video, we will going to illustrate simple interest and compound interest. And of course, we are going to discuss the different terms that you are going to encounter. Let's start with the lender or creditor. It is a person or institution who invests the money or makes the funds available. Okay, they are the one who will invest so that the funds will be available. We have the borrower or the debtor, a person or institution who owes the money or avails of funds from the lender. Okay, so there are the debtors or the borrower. Origin or loan date. Date on which money is received by the borrower. So this is the starting date wherein the debtor received the money that they are going to borrow in the lender or creditor. We also have the repayment date or maturity date. It is a date on which the money borrowed or loan is to be completely repaid. Time or term. Amount of time in years the money is borrowed or invested. So time is the starting date or the origin to the maturity date or the end where you have completely repaid the money that you borrowed. And of course, we have the principal. It is the amount of money borrowed or invested on the origin date. So the actual amount that you borrowed in the lender. That is what we call the principal. And we also have the following terms. We have the rate. It is usually in percent form. And the rate is charged by the lender. The interest. The amount earned for the use of money. Okay, the interest is usually set by the lender. And the simple interest. It is interest that is computed on the principal and then added to it. So simple interest is the principal plus the interest. Compound interest. Interest that is computed on the principal and also on the accumulated past interest. So later we will going to discuss the differences between simple interest and compound interest. Maturity value or future value. The amount of money after T year that the lender receives from the borrower and on the maturity date. So those are the terms that you are going to encounter in simple interest and compound interest. Now let us go into illustrating the simple interest and the compound interest. And now we're going to illustrate the simple interest and the compound interest. So let's have this problem. Suppose you want 10,000 pesos and you plan to invest it for 5 years. A cooperative group offers 2% simple interest per year. A bank offers 2% compounded annually. Which will you choose and why? So we have two different options. We have the cooperative group that offers a simple interest of 2% per year. And a bank that offers 2% interest compounded annually. Now, what are you going to choose? The simple interest or the compound interest? So let us first try to solve what would be the value after 5 years. So in our first year, So we have 5 years. So our first year, time is one. In our first year, we have principal, we have 10,000 times our interest is 2%. In decimal, 2%. Just move twice on the left. So 2, move twice on the left, point. That will become 0.02 times the number of year is 1. In your first year, the interest will be 10,000 times 0.02. That will be the interest. So you have 200 pesos as interest for the first year. So after 1 year, your money will become 200 plus 10,000. Your money will become 10,200. Your money will become 10,200. Now, on the second year, we have 10,000 times 0.02 times 2. So the interest will be 10,000 times 0.02 times 2. This will become 400. So on the second year, your money will become 10,400. Now we're going to compute on the fifth year. So we have on the third year, we have 10,000 times 0.02 times 3. On the fourth year, we have 10,000 times 0.02 times 4. And on the fifth year, we have 10,000 times 0.02 times 5. Now press in your calculator. So 10,000 times 0.02 point times 3, 600. So on the third year, your money will become 10,600. On the fourth year, 10,000 times 0.02 times 4, that is 800. Your money will become 10,800. And on the fifth year, this will become 10,000 times 0.02 times 5, that is 1,000. Your money will become 11,000. So this will be your money after 5 years in the co-op group, a cooperative group, with 2% simple interest annually, 11,000. Now let us compare using the bank offers 2% compounded annually. So on the first year we have the principal 10,000 times 2%, 0.02 times 1. So the interest will be 200. So 200 plus the principal, that will be 10,200. They are the same in the first year. Now on the second year in bank, instead of using the 10,000, we are going to use the accumulated money. So here we have 10,200. So that is the difference between the two, times our interest 0.02 times yearly compounded with 2%. So still 1 here, because that is annually, so 1. So 10,200 times 0.02 times 1. So using your calculator, times 0 point times 1, that is 204. So 204 plus 10,200. So your money will become 10,404. Comparing the two, you have 4 pesos increase in bank. And on the third year, we have 10,404 times 0.02, that is the interest, times annually, which is 1, is equal to times 0.02, use your calculator. This is 208.08 plus 10,404. Your money on the third year is 10,612.08. So, close. You have increase of 12 pesos in the amount after 3 years. And on the fourth year, we have 10,612.08 times 0.02 times 1 times 0.02. We have here 212.24 plus 10,612.08. Use your calculator. This will become 10,824.32. And lastly, we have 10,824.32 times 0.02 times 1 times 0.02, 216.49 plus 10,824.32. So your money will become 11,040.81 centavos. So let us compare the two: the co-op group with simple interest and the bank with 2% interest compounded annually. So 11,000 versus 11,040. So a 40 pesos difference between the two banks. So if you're going to choose, of course you're going to choose the bank that is compounded annually compared to the co-op group, which has a simple interest. So that is the comparison between the simple interest and the compound interest. Thank you for watching Senior Pablo TV.